Hello gamers and welcome to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity 2 Deadfire by Obsidian. I've just recently finished Pillars of Eternity 1. I actually played it in 2015 for like half the game or so. And then I've just recently started playing it again and also swiftly finished it so that I can start with Deadfire. So in this Let's Play I'm going to do like a 5 hours of Deadfire approach, which basically means there will be 15-ish episodes in a short succession, like every other day. And then if I like the game a lot, and possibly also if you like the game, so basically if anyone is interested in watching it, I am immediately going to continue it as a Let's Play. Otherwise I might continue at a later stage or just play it on my own. So if you like Pillars of Eternity 2, please watch it, or play it actually, it's even better maybe. So what I did is I've already changed some auto pause settings. What you can do is you can set your own, you can do kind of the settings of decisions you've made in the previous game, including the White March DLC. Very recommendable. I can actually recommend playing the game if you haven't played it yet. You should possibly still play it. Up here you can see the version of the game, I guess. This is with the current beta patch, it's 13th of May. And there has been a beta patch that fixes, for example, that the history of Eder is not in certain circumstances, if it's a specific outcome. He will basically have the wrong story ending, but that's been fixed in the beta patch, so I've actually installed the beta patch. But let's start. You can play relaxed. For players who are new to real-time pause combat, or who find classic difficulty a little too challenging, I'll go for classic. That's what I already did in Pillars of Eternity 1. Some fights are very challenging. I don't like scaling in any direction, so I'll leave it deactivated. If a foe is too strong, I should, you know, start try later. If a foe is too weak, then I've earned it. So I don't like scaling. Okay, let's start the game. It's a bit annoying that at the top right it shows me the version all the time. I hope that stops. The lowering symbol is new.
Eora, a world where mortals live, die, and are reborn through the turning of the wheel. The cycle of reincarnation watched over by the gods and made possible through pillars of a mystical substance known as Audra. 5 years ago, you traveled from your home to the Deerwood, a nation that had waged war against the incarnated god of light, Aethys, resulting in his destruction. The country suffered from a plague of hollowborn, infants born without souls, that many believed was punishment for killing a god. In an ancient, secluded ruin, you witnessed a secret ritual that inadvertently transformed you into a Watcher. One who can see and speak with souls. The ritual also gave you horrible visions, waking nightmares of a past life that threatened your sanity. To put them to rest, you pursued the man who had led the ritual. A seemingly immortal agent of the gods, known as Theos Ix Arcanon.
Well, I've actually killed him.
With divine assistance, you confronted and defeated Theos.
I destroyed his soul.
Ending your visions and resolving the Hollowborn crisis. In so doing, you also learned the great secret that Theos had protected. That the ancient empire of Angwith had transformed themselves into gods.
Well, at least some of them.
Your visions finally put to rest. You retired to the castle of Cad Nua, built atop a massive statue of pure Audra, where you ruled in relative peace and prosperity.
Yeah, and I built everything I could in the castle, and also completed the endless dungeon beneath. Also recommendable, lots of tiny nice,
made a nice story.
Stories.
You fixing up that old keep, lifting the curse? Must have told it 100 times. But something got to gnaw at me. Thinking the spirits there weren't really at rest. But maybe the gods weren't finished with us.
Oh.
Dream that when my god came back, he would forgive us.
Well, his god, the guy speaking is Eda, one of the companions. And he used to believe in Eothas.
Sooner or later, we all have to wake up.
Now we know where the loading symbol comes from.
So you wake to a sleepless world, the in-between of life and death. Follow your memories. You have been here before.
You have seen past the shroud. You are a watcher now, and a watcher you will stay.
A watcher sees souls, knows their pasts, and the souls see them back.
A dubious honor, inheriting a fortress both broken and cursed.
What is a god? A higher power? A rewarder of good deeds and punisher of the wicked?
Gods aren't real, but something else entirely. Something created by people.
And did you ever consider that these were things you were never meant to understand? That their comprehension is beyond you?
Let the world see. Let them decide what to do.
Yeah, and the wheel basically is there are souls, and then you get back on the wheel is basically you get reborn in a new body. But usually, you don't keep your memories.
An aged dwarf shares this strange floating platform with you. His face is creased by so many wrinkles that his features lie buried amid shadowy pockets of skin. Still, the dwarf's well-practiced habits have left telltale tracks of a welcoming rictus across his visage.
This is new that they read that out.
You can see his smile coming before it blooms, reshaping the dwarf's face from a hanging sack of flesh into something resembling an oddly carved, merry gore, replete with unhealthy bumps and discolored splotches.
I'd probably die if I had to read everything out.
Sit, please. Sit.
Yeah, it's okay.
Please.
Tutorials interact, okay. Yeah, I've managed that just about.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us, Watcher of Cadnua.
The gaunt woman seated at the table is clad in time-worn black armor that seems too massive for her to move in.
It's a shame that they've destroyed my castle.
A pale, slender neck rises from the gorget, topped by a hollow face. The milky skin stretched across it is delicate and translucent, like parchment that has been scraped clean too many times. She is preoccupied with the arrangement of cards on the table between you. With each movement, her armor squeaks and groans as though bearing an incredible weight. She places a final card, gives a nod of satisfaction, and raises her eyes to meet yours.
Your brush with the divine has drained you of your powers, fractured your memories. Look upon these cards. They represent the courses of your life. You alone know best how they flowed. Arrange them to fit what you remember.
Examine the cards to choose your legacy. I want to import my save game. I hope this is now the latest save game. Okay, today is the 13th. Yeah, that basically, because I've completed the game kind of yesterday, or the day before yesterday, and I wanted to make some, and there was no warning that that I can't, you know, continue with some of the other quests as soon as I jump into the pit. So I loaded the game before I actually jumped into the pit and finished, I think, two companion quests and Raidrex Castle. I went back to it, and what else? The Orlan Baby. And I think that's about it. And some bounty hunts, just because I felt like it. There was 83 hours, it says here now. And the total time I've spent in Pillars is like 98. So it's basically when I had to load a game and stuff. Because I've lost a fight, for example. Okay. Act for 8 months. Yeah, that should be it. 417 today, that sounds about right. I'm very relieved. You can see that's my character, it's a Cypher. And I had Ida, the Paladin girl, Aloth, and Durance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the sixth one is not shown, that was the main, usually the Ranger. Seragrina or Sagina or something.
Does everything appear to be in order?
Yeah, I don't know how I can actually check that, but I guess so.
Good. Welcome to the Beyond. I am Bereth. One half, anyway.
Well, she points a finger in the direction Bereth of the dwarf who led you.
Is basically,
though the movement is slight, her gauntlet
the twin, a twin-faced god, and he's a god of, or she, of death. Okay. Continue.
The dwarf's rictus returns as he nods in the woman's direction. The gods offered you boons in exchange for resolving the Hollowborn crisis. What did you do with the souls?
Okay, do I have to click everything now? Hylea, restore the souls to the Hollowborn. That's what I did.
Tell me, do you remember when we last met?
Well, do I? I remain silent. Hall of Stars in Twin Elms? Did I really? Yeah, she was the statue. One of the statues. Or shrines, basically. And I did a task for her.
You came to that tower seeking our aid. You prayed for help in reaching Theos, beyond the Court of Penitence, but would not pledge yourself to me.
Yeah, I did not. Because all you had to do, you could do like four quests for gods. We needed to do at least one in order to safely jump into the pit and survive. I did all four quests, but they all wanted you to do something else with the souls. So basically the plot was, this bad guy, Theos, he stole the souls from babies that were born. So they were born hollow, like without their soul. And he used a machine for that, and he wanted to give all the souls to Vudica. And Boudica is like the former queen of all the gods, but she'd been overthrown by the other gods, who are anyway not real gods. And yeah, so he wanted to restore her power basically by giving her all the souls. And you could do several things with the souls. You could return them to the Hollowborn, you could destroy them, you could put them back into the cycle immediately, you could also give them to Boudica. So what I wanted to do is kind of, that was my whole purpose, is kind of defeat the plague and give the Hollowborn their souls back if possible. So that's what I did, and Hylea was the goddess who had that, and I actually pledged to her.
Still, a pledge unmade stands fairer in this court than a pledge broken.
Exactly. And since every god wanted something else, I couldn't, you know, pledge to all. It said that there might be repercussions. And I think if you had betrayed Hylea, for example, she would have destroyed the countryside or something. I don't.
She places a card in the middle of the arrangement. A bell tower with no bell. Her fingertips slowly drag away from the card, faintly creaking as they retreat across the table. You had need of the gods once before. Now it seems we have need of you.
Interesting. And the gods actually wanted me to also stop stop Theos in any case, and Boudica, because they didn't want her power restored. So it's not like they just helped me, I also helped them.
The being that occupied Odnua's statue beneath your castle was the dead god, Aeothus. Of this, we are certain. What we do not know is what his intentions are. Though Aeothus stole a large fragment of your soul, you were strong enough to survive the onslaught and enter the in-between.
Aeothus, he is the god of rebirth, redemption, dawn, spring, and light. Traditionally shown as a man bearing a candle and wearing a silver crown. He actually was pretty mean to my castle. He recently reformed his essence in the statue of Maros Nua beneath Kat Nua. In the process of pulling himself from the endless paths, he destroyed the castle and left the watcher of Kat Nua at the brink of death. And the in-between refers to the shadow world that souls briefly wander after death on their way to the beyond. It has been described as a hazy landscape, empty but for the glow of other souls, Aedra, and Watchers. This is the space that Watchers peer into when they observe and speak to lost souls and soul fragments. Even the gods cannot reach it. Well, apparently, Beretha can. We look like we have tentacles.
You and he are still connected. He has chosen a body made of living Aedra, perfused with the power of thousands of souls, including yours. It should be little difficulty for an experienced watcher to find him.
Am I dead?
No. But neither is your body truly alive. Your lungs draw breath, your heart pumps blood, but your flesh is as soulless as a Hollowborn. That is, until I return you.
Okay.
She delicately places a card upright on the table. The art depicts souls flowing out of a pillar of Aedra.
Okay, so I actually get my buddy back. Well, I'd like to find him as much as you would. He destroyed my castle and killed who knows how many people around it. I've had enough of dealing with the gods, all of you. Why should I care about any of this? Then let's get on with it. It doesn't matter how much you threaten me. I'm not doing this. Well, I'm going to kill him because he destroyed my castle.
I know. It is my business to know. 322 in Kat Nua and your surrounding lands.
That's a lot.
Their souls remain in Aeothus still. You have the power to save them. Serve me and I will return you to your body. Or don't, and return to the wheel.
Well, I don't want to serve this person. But if I go take the wheel, I lose my memories. Lore-wise, I don't think I would, because yeah, because you know the game wouldn't start, or I don't know. Let's get on with it.
Good.
I wonder what happens if I play a It's Baratha, I think, or whatever. A priest.
Before you return
or
to
priest
anyone
of Eothas.
Herald, you must remember who you were. The last whisper of life and death.
For a moment, the sockets of her eyes darken, leaving the pits of a death's head gazing out at you.
Yeah, in the Pillars of Eternity 1, some lines were spoken, many were not, and the narrator was never read out. The narration was never read out.
When you can picture your own face, the Beyond will lead you back to your own kind, to the world of mortals.
It's character creation time. But we're going to do that in the next episode. Thanks a lot for watching. Until then, bye for now.